we should just call this episode "The Mystery of Safe Fonts and Why It's So Damned Hard to Pin Them Down."
Great, be
because it's constantly changing. You know, we've talked about this a few times. In fact, in episode 7 on choosing fonts, we explained that safe fonts are those that are installed on most operating systems. So most operating systems, Office versions, and devices. So they're referred to as safe fonts because they're not going to get substituted with something like Arial or Calibri when that font is not present. So this is really critical for people who build templates, and it's also critical for those who are sharing presentations. So it's not just templates, it's beyond templates. It's folks who need to share presentations with others who need to be able to edit them, or at least view them as they were intended in the PowerPoint format. So safe fonts, it's the story continues. All right, so some of the caveats, right? Many fonts can't be embedded at all because of the font licensing. When you're sharing and viewing files on Dropbox, for instance, or other storage sites, you don't have the ability to install fonts there. Many fonts do get substituted in that instance. So editability becomes a question if someone is going to be accessing your file online. So fast forward to 2018. We've got a lot of users on Office 365, both Windows and Mac. So we have updates. Everything you see grayed out here is either not present in Office 365 for Windows, or it's substituted with something else on the Mac. Maybe only a bold version exists. So I've grayed those out. That knocks out more of our original safe fonts.